What you are looking at in this spooky and eerie Halloween special is a burning crater reminiscent of a media portrayal of the depths of hell. Almost like death has an aura from this fire, any plants which attempt to pop up right next to its crater rim have died. Adding to this is the fact that every year, thousands, if not tens of thousands, of creepy arachnids known as sun spiders willingly jump to their doom as if something horrible is attracting them. And this is why this geologic formation is informally referred to as the Gates of Hell or Door to Hell, being officially known as the Darvaza Gas Crater. While there is nothing supernatural related to its formation, it is a fascinating example of what can go wrong in large natural gas fields. As various types of natural gas, largely methane, are what has been continuously burning for 53 years straight without stopping. This natural gas is supplied by such a large reserve of underlying material that it could continue to burn for many more decades, perhaps even hundreds of years. So, how exactly did this spooky geologic oddity form? The Darvaza Gas Crater is located in the interior desert of central Turkmenistan, where it is situated 254 kilometers or 158 miles north of the nation's capital city, Ashgabat. This crater marks the site of one of the more than 100 large natural gas fields which exist in the country, which is absurdly rich in this resource on a world stage. In fact, despite only accounting for 0.33% of the planet's landmass, Turkmenistan contains 6.29% of the world's natural gas, placing it as fifth among all nations, being specifically ahead of Saudi Arabia and Venezuela, but behind the United States. Turkmenistan's natural gas is largely held in structural traps such as anticlines, which are fed natural gas by largely rocks of Jurassic or Cretaceous age, but also sometimes Paleocene age. This natural gas originated in these rocks due to the decomposition of organic material due to heat and pressure at depth over millions of years. This largely occurred through the remains of ancient marine microorganisms, as this section of Turkmenistan was the site of an ocean or shallow sea between 180 and 45 million years ago, hence the age range of the aforementioned rocks. In the Darvaza gas field, the underlying low permeability rock was a type of carbonate rock, but in areas this carbonate rock had cracks and cavities in it, allowing overlying loose sediment to seep into it into spaces where natural gas once was below. The natural gas then rose, forming a large cavity underneath the surface which was enlarged by repeated Soviet exploration wells created during the middle of the 20th century. Finally, in 1971, a rig right on top of the crater caused the rock overlying the large cavity to completely collapse, destroying the rig but thankfully not harming any people. Soon, nearby plants and animals started dying en masse due to the released heavier-than-air natural gases which displaced breathable air, and this became such a problem that it threatened the ability for nearby natural gas wells to be made. As a result, much like flaring which is done to remove excess natural gas today, Soviet scientists from a distance threw a match into the newly formed crater, hoping all of the natural gas would burn off and work could be resumed in only a few weeks' time. However, the natural gas underlying this crater was far larger than anyone imagined at the time and is still burning within this 70-meter wide and 30-meter deep crater at the present. While it does currently serve as a tourist attraction, it represents a major problem to the nation's government. Since the fire started, $636 million worth of natural gas has burned into the atmosphere at a loss of 38 cents worth of material per second. If anyone was to somehow manage to extinguish this long-term fire, then some or all of the $12 million worth of natural gas this crater emits every year could be captured and sold. As a final note, I would like to thank my new YouTube channel member X the Canadian X for supporting this channel.